The sound of gravel crunching beneath my shoes scatters the birds who have come to perch on the smooth marble gravestones. The pictures of the deceased peer back at the birds with distant stares forged decades ago. The grave of my great uncle shows him in his early 20s. He's dressed immaculately, delicate pencil mustache, soft, caring eyes. He exudes calm control. I wipe cobwebs from around his picture and think about my Zia Nicola, his wife. In her living room, in her small medieval apartment, she meticulously kept a small shrine of her late husband's personal effects. His smoking pipes, cufflinks, portrait pictures, letters and more. My father's Italian, from Siena, and as a child I moved to Italy with my mother and sister at age 6 to learn Italian and gain an appreciation of my father's culture. Growing up, I listened to a few stories about my great uncle Dante, but only two stuck with me. The first came from my grandfather, who recounted that his sister-in-law, the same Zia Nicola, kept her husband's blazer in her bedroom and would speak to it as if speaking to her dead husband when there was any major decision to be made in her life. My grandfather would smile as he recounted telling her, "Don't expect the blazer to talk back anytime soon." And he would chuckle to himself before his eyes would moisten with emotion. The second story was told by Zia Nicola herself, where she recounted how her husband was captured by the Nazis and transported to a prison camp in Germany. He spent just over a year in Stalag 7A, and after the camp was liberated by American forces in late 1945, he and his fellow Italian internees walked back to Italy. It took them just over 2 months. The fact that he walked back to Italy always stuck with me. He subsisted on raw potatoes stolen from fields, water from streams and springs, and the generosity of war-ravaged peasants along the way. Zio Dante spoke very little about his year in captivity, apparently. Will I be the last person to think about him? And when I die, I expect he would gently fade away from existing through my words and memories. I hope one day to gaze fondly at birds dancing on my own grave. And I wonder, who will be the last person to vividly remember me and my story?